Brothers and sisters, today the fifth Sunday of Lent, and we are approaching the Holy Week. Next week will be Palm Sunday, and we are going to start to contemplate more closely the Passion of Christ, who gave His own life for us. In this Mass, there's some intentions for intercession, the intention of John Cunningham for the repose of the soul, Rosa Conchesia Gomez. Thanksgiving for the wedding anniversary of Mr. and Mrs. Crispin Serrano Jr. Thanksgiving to Alan, thanksgiving Mass for Alan, Maria Salvia, and family. And the birthday of Consuelo Fernandez, and for the soul of Martin de Ramos, and all of your intention that you may have. And as a reminder, that after Mass, there will be the Station of the Cross, so everyone is welcome. And Father Tommaso asked me to let you know also that there will be another collection for Ukraine after the communion. My dear brothers and sisters, we come together with confidence, even though many times we have done mistakes. We are against God's will, but we believe in His love and compassion for us. I confess to my God,
dear my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned.
A reading from the prophet Isaiah. Thus says the Lord, who made a way through the sea, a path in the great waters, who put chariots and horses in the field and a powerful army, which lay there never to rise again, snuffed out, put out like a wick. No need to recall the past, no need to think about what was done before. See, I am doing a new deed. Even now, it comes to light. Can you not see it? Yes, I am making a road in the wilderness, paths in the wilds. The wild beasts will honor me, jackals and ostriches, because I am putting water in the wilderness, give my chosen people drink. The people I have formed for myself will sing my praises. This is the word of the Lord. Is still to come.
calls us upwards to receive in Christ Jesus. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Please all stand for gospel adoration.
The scribes and Pharisees brought a woman along who had been caught committing adultery and make her stand there in full view of everybody. They said to Jesus, "Master, this woman was caught in the very act of committing adultery. And Moses has ordered us in the law to condemn women like this to death by stoning. What have you said?" They asked him this as a test, looking for something to use against him. But Jesus bent down and started writing on the ground with his finger. As they persisted with their question, he looked up and said, "If there is one of you who has not sinned, let him be the first to throw a stone at her." Then he bent down and wrote on the ground again. When they heard this, they went away one by one, beginning with the eldest, until Jesus was left alone with the woman, who remained standing there. He looked up and said, "Woman, where are they? Has no one condemned you?" "No one, sir," she replied. "Neither do I condemn you." Said Jesus, "Go away and don't sin anymore." My brothers and sisters, this is the gospel of the Lord. About 2,500 years ago, there was a man named Socrates. He was well-known as a teacher and a philosopher. One of his famous words was, "A life without investigation or examination, whether all my lives or my relationship with others, for example, is not worth living for." What he means is that our lives would become meaningless when we cannot think or reflect on them more deeply. For several years, Socrates spent his time teaching young people in Athens and challenging their fixed thoughts by using different kinds of conversation, dialogues, and inquiries. His purpose was to help them, these young people, not to have pride, to claim that they already know everything. Instead, they can be humble enough to learn new knowledge and open up new ways how they can live their lives and have good relationships with other people in society more meaningfully. Today's gospel might explain why our fixed thoughts without examination or investigation more reflectively can impact our society than we possibly imagine. While Jesus was preaching, the scribes and Pharisees came to him and challenged him with their fixed interpretation of the law of Moses. They brought the woman caught in the act of adultery and tested Jesus whether he would condemn her according to the law or not. And we know that the scribes and the Pharisees always interpreted the laws literally, and the Jews relied on their interpretation. And as we heard from the gospel, according to the law, the woman who was caught in adultery must be stoned unto death. If we try to step back a bit and reflect upon this gospel, we can feel something very scary here. This was not just the punishment in private, but in public, with a group of people, maybe many people. And to be culpable of punishing someone vulnerable like this woman, I think the crowd, the people there, first must totally believe that the interpretation of the scribes and Pharisees was correct. We can imagine that the hearts of these people must be filled with emotions, especially anger, that easily led them to harmful actions toward this woman. However, we know that when people get angry, they become less rational and cannot step back to think carefully beyond what they have already made up their minds. Facing with the furious crowd, Jesus challenged them with his response. "Let him who is without sin among you be the first to throw a stone at her." Jesus' statement broke the angry crowd into individuals. Once again, each person was implicitly forced to live from that anger as a crowd, as a group. The anger that blinded their eyes and come to examine himself or herself instead. The gospel describes how the crowd was slowly dismantled. They went away one by one after they examined himself or herself, beginning with the eldest. And I think how Jesus not only dissolved the furious crowd, but also their fixed thoughts on the interpretation of the law. Jesus showed them the other way of understanding God's love, God who does not simply punish us, but God who looks at us and judges us with his love and compassion, no matter who we are or what we did. At the same time, we are called to have the same compassionate heart for one another. My dear brothers and sisters, I think today we live in a society that moves and changes very quickly. The society often puts us in the position that we must only follow the flow of what's going on or what other people say without careful examining what's going on. In these circumstances, we do not have time to stop and think more deeply about our own lives, relationship with others, and even with God. I think this time of Lenten season is always a great opportunity for us to step back and examine how did I spend my life in the past? How do I live in the present? And how should I live better in the future? In this Eucharist, let us ask the grace of the Lord that we will not judge others with our own standards. Instead, we are always open to contemplating God's love and learning from his compassionate heart so that we can do the same with love, compassion to our brothers and sisters. In this way, we can live our lives more meaningfully, not only for ourselves, but become an instrument of peace for the common good of our society. My dear brothers and sisters, let us stand and give you more faith to get the peace with our wishes. I believe in God, my Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth, and Jesus Christ, the Son of the Lord, was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered in the Holy Spirit, was crucified by the blood of the Spirit, descended into hell, and the third day rose again.
Let us pray to our Holy Father, Pope Francis, and all who serve as leaders in our Church, that they may continue to proclaim the merciful love of God. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
Let us pray for peace in the world, that hatred may give you way to love, and violence to reconciliation. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
Let us pray to our parish community that by keeping Lent well, we may continue, we may come to the celebration of Easter with hearts and minds renewed. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
For all who have been bereaved or are suffering the loss of a loved one, that the Lord will heal their wounds and fill them with hope in the resurrection. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
For all who are sick or housebound, that they may know the gentle touch of God's healing love. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
For the faithful departed and those recently deceased, that they may come to the heavenly banquet in God's eternal kingdom. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
All these prayers we leave it to our Mother, Blessed Virgin Mary, as we pray.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners.
Father of love, you have planted in our hearts the hope of eternal life. Hear our prayer and bring us and all our beloved ones to the joy of the kingdom of heaven. We make this prayer to Christ our Lord.
Amen. Thank you.
The blood of the new and eternal covenant, remission be poured out for you and for me for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. Remember, Lord, your church spread to all the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis of Pope and with St. Bishop and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all have died in mercy, welcome them to the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, St. Joseph, the spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have blessed you to all ages, we may marry to be poets to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, make you Father, in unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Misericordia.
face and so be with her. This others hope to suffer after that.
Lord,
I have
no
Thank you.
for the fellow prayer blessing, I would like to give thanks for everyone who held this Mass, for our young people here who serve this Mass, for beautiful musician and choir, for readers, for those who have our collections, and all of you who are present here that make this Mass more lively. So, as a reminder for those who would like to participate in the Station of the Cross, you are most welcome after the Mass. Let us stand for the prayer. We pray, Almighty God, that we may always be counted among the members of Christ, in whose body and blood we have communion, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless us, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Mass already ended. Let us go in peace to love and serve one another.
Thanks be to God.
We'll take.